So, hey guys, this is just a spur of a moment thing. I'm going to show you how I activate or how I enable the console. I'm going to put the link to the Dragon Age wiki in the description of this video. And I haven't prepared anything, so this is just gonna, you just have to take it as I do it. So what you want to do is you want to find your Dragon Age 2 exe file, and you would probably find it under C program files, Dragon Age bin ship folder. But since I installed my Dragon Age under games, Dragon Age 2 bin ship, I find it here. And it doesn't actually say Dragon Age 2.exe. But I know it's this because it's an application. And if I right click, I can check the properties, and this is the exe file. Right, so let's go back and look what the next step is. So what I want to do is make a shortcut on your desktop or wherever. So right click on the shortcut. So let's make a shortcut first. Where is it? Oh, I have to shut down this as well. So, send to desktop, create a shortcut. Right, so let me drag this into view for you. Hang on. Here we go. That's my background. Sailor Moon. Sailor Moon. Well, anyway, I can't sing, so this is the shortcut I'm going to work with. And so what did it say? I should right click on the shortcut, choose properties, and then add the following to the end of the line in the target field. So I'm going to copy this. Copy. Right, and it should look something like that. And I have to remember that there are supposed to be a space. Right, so let's see. Properties and target. Paste and space. Right, am I doing this correctly now? Yes, it should look exactly like that, which it does. If I put them side by side, oh, sorry about this, guys. As I said, I didn't think this through. I just thought, oh, I'm doing this. I might as well start recording. So this is what it should look like, and this is what it's looking like. And then, okay. So I'm going to do some other things. Let's see. Wait. Oh, I need to pause so I find the stuff I'm looking for. Okay, I found it almost straight away. So, once you're in game, you need to hit a shortcut to get up the console. So, and this should be in BioWare, Dragon Age 2 settings, key bindings, init. So let's go this, and that should be in my documents. So BioWare, Dragon Age 2. Wait, where is it? In the settings, right. Key bindings. Right. Okay, so these are all the key bindings. Usually you do stuff like this. You can set your key bindings in game. And it looks like this. If I just drag it. And yeah, so I wanted a suggestion. I wanted to make a suggestion. I wanted to take a su so open console 0 is where what I'm looking for. And button X. I'm just gonna copy that. I'm wondering if I'm using button X for anything though. Maybe I need to check that. Let me open up Dragon Age 2. I'm gonna pause. You know, I might be too lazy to edit this video, so I'm just gonna upload it as it is because I'm so lazy. Right. So, I'm looking for if I have X somewhere. Because sometimes I do that. I like using X. And I'm not using X anywhere. So that's fine. I can do this then. Right. I'm just gonna close this down, quit. Because this is not the version of the game I'm gonna use. So I copied this. So now I'm looking for open console. So that should be somewhere under... open console 0. Here we go. And grave, that's like the... I think it's like the little tilde thing. It looks like this. Oh, wait. Okay. There we go. And I don't even need to use these kinds of things either. I don't even know what they're called in English. And just to make sure, I'm going to be searching for button X. So... just gonna show, okay, so and of course save. Okay, so I'm gonna pause again just to make sure that I've got everything straight. Alright, so this is the console version of the XE, and I actually have another one. This is a regular Dragon Age 2. So I don't know how I'm gonna know them apart. I think I'm gonna leave this just in the middle here somewhere. I'll make Sailor Moon hold it. So we start the game. So there are two things I need to say. The first one is that using any console commands will actually kind of break your game. So you should be really super careful if you're playing a save game that you really want to keep. And whoops. So for me to check if this is actually working, because a console command is invisible, if I hit X, I shouldn't be able to walk around, and I can't do that right now. And so I hit escape, and come on, escape. And now I have to hit enter. Now I can walk. Okay, so that worked. I tried to walk and I couldn't. I can also, if I hit X, and let me just run script cc _ upgrade. So I should write run script cc _ upgrade and then enter, and I get enchantment. So now I know this thing works, and I can do what I wanted to do. And that is to change Meryl's approval. I want to get her into 50 rival. I want to get Anders into 50 rival. So I'm just going to look up the command for that. And if you go to the website, you got all the general commands. And if you go down to, here we go, did I go past it maybe? Oh god. Right, oh here it is. So the command, companion debug commands. So, I want to. Oh yes, mirrorless not working. I forgot about that. But I can use Anders ZZ debug. And so what I want to do is. Oh, my phone's ringing. Hang on. Sorry about that. As I said, this recording wasn't planned. I don't think I'll have much longer to do this. So it's I want to put him as rival and not crisis. So what I need to do is go run script zz under slash and debug Anders. Is that what I need to do? Let's try. So X and then go run script CC under slash and under slash debug. Right. Change his approval or romance. Remove approval, and we want rival, right? So, I can opt out also, but these will just add like. Or wait, I need to just check. I need to. I want him to be 50 rivalry, so. Rival. And leave. And there, because he was so low, or so, he should be at exactly 50% towards rival. So that's how it works. So thanks for watching and have fun trying all the different console commands. Bye.